In this video, I'm going to talk about balancing of chemical equations. Let us start with this example. Reaction of iron and hydrochloric acid can produce iron 2 chloride and hydrogen. Balancing of equation is based on the law of conservation of mass. It means atoms, they're not going to destroy or produced during the chemical reaction. They just have different arrangements. So for each type of atoms, we should have same number or equal number on the both sides of the chemical equation. Let us start with iron. On the left side, we have one iron, and on the right side, we have one iron. So iron right now, it's balanced. For chlorine, we have two chlorine here, but on the left, we have only one chlorine. So if you put two in front of HCl, right now we have two chlorine on the left side too. So right now in this equation, iron is balanced, chlorine is also balanced. Then we need to double check for hydrogen. On the right side, we have two hydrogen, so we also have two hydrogen on the left side. So this equation right now is balanced. So we should have one iron, two HCl, one iron chloride, and one hydrogen. Let's have another example for iron. Reaction of iron and oxygen. We produce iron 3 oxide. As you can see here, on the left side, we have one iron, and on the right side, we have two iron. So we need to put two in front of iron on the left side. So right now, iron atoms are balanced. Then we need to balance oxygen. On the right side, we have 3 oxygen, and on the left side, we have 2 oxygen. So how we can find the number for oxygen? We need to divide the 3 number of oxygen by these 2. So we will have 3 over 2 here. We are not able to have fractional number for balancing of equation. We need to have always whole number. So what we can do is multiplying the whole equation by denominator of this fraction. I'm going to rewrite this equation again. When we multiply these numbers, it's going to multiply by each of these coefficients. So 2 times 2 for the iron, it will be 4 iron. 2 times 3 over 2 will be 3 for oxygen. And 2 times 1, it will be 2 iron oxide. It's good to always double check at the end of the balancing to make sure all atoms at the both sides, they are equals. We have 4 iron here. We have 2 times 2, 4 iron here. 3 times 2, we have 6 oxygen on the left side. And 2 times 3, we have 6 oxygen on the right side too. So this is our balance equations here. Let's have another example. So let's balance combustion reaction for methane. So reaction of methane and oxygen, it produces carbon dioxide and water. I'm going to start with carbon here. On methane, we have one carbon, and on carbon dioxide, we also have one carbon. So if we have one and one for these two molecules, carbon atoms are balanced. Then for hydrogen, we have 4 hydrogen here. And for water, we have 2 hydrogen. So we need to put 2 in front of water. Then 2 times 2, it will be 4 again. Right now, carbon and hydrogen are balanced. Then we need to balance oxygen. On the right side, we have 2 oxygen from carbon dioxide, and we have 2 oxygen from water. So the total on the right side, we have 4 oxygen. On the left side, we have 2 oxygen, so we need to put number 2 in front of O2. Then this equation is balanced. Let's have another example for combustion. Here is combustion of C2H6 or ethane. I'm going to start with carbon again. On the left side, we have 2 carbon. So on the right side, I'm going to put number 2 in front of carbon dioxide. And of course, ethane is 1. Then we have 6 hydrogen on the left side and only 2 hydrogen on the right side. So I need to put 3, then 3 times 2 is going to be 6 hydrogen on the both sides. Right now carbon and hydrogen are balanced, so we need to balance oxygen. On the right side, I have 2 times 2 oxygen, so 4 oxygen for carbon dioxide, and 3 times 1, 3 oxygen for water. So in total, we have 7 oxygen on the right side. Again, I need to put a fractional number. If I divide this 7 by these 2, the answer will be 7 over 2. So right now this equation is balanced, but it is not correct because we should have whole number. So again, I need to multiply the whole equation by the denominator of this fraction, that is 2 again. So this number 2 multiplied to all of these numbers. So I'm going to have 2 of ethane, 7O2, 4 carbon dioxide and 6 water. So this is the balanced equation. Let's work on the composition of dinitrogen pentoxide. It produces nitrogen dioxide and oxygen. So at the beginning, I'm going to balance nitrogen. On the left side, we have 2 nitrogen, and on the right side, we have 1 nitrogen. Then I need to put number 2 here. Right now, nitrogen are balanced, but on the left side, we have 5 oxygen, and on the right side, we have 6 oxygen, 4 from NO2 and 2 from O2. So I can put a half here for oxygen, and then this equation is balanced right now. Instead of 2, we have 1. So we should have 5 oxygen on the both sides right now. Again, the problem is we have fractional coefficient. So I need to multiply the whole equation by 2 and then rewrite the equation. Then I have 2 of N2O5, 2 times 2, 4NO2, and 2 times 1 over 2 will be 1. And this is our balanced equation. For the next example, we have reaction of potassium hydroxide and phosphoric acid. First, I'm going to start with potassium. On the right side, we have 3 potassium, and on the left side, we have 1 potassium. So I'm going to put 3 in front of potassium hydroxide. Then if we look at to the equations, we can see we have 1 PO4 here and 1 PO4 here. When we have polyatomic anions, we don't need to balance all the atoms. We can just make sure we have same number of polyatomic anions. So because we have same number of PO4 on the both sides, I can say phosphoric acid already is balanced. So right now I need to double check with oxygen and hydrogen. Here on the left side, we have 3 hydrogen here and 3 hydrogen here. So in total, we have 6 hydrogen here. So I need to put 3 in front of water. And we can double check again for the oxygen. We have 3 oxygen here. We have 4 oxygen here. We have 4 oxygen here. And we have 3 oxygen here. So on the both sides, we have 7 oxygen. So all of the elements are balanced right now. So this is our balance equation. Here is another example. Let's work on reaction of silicon tetrachloride and water. I'm going to start with chlorine atom. Silicon already is balanced on the left side and right side. On the left side, we have 4 chlorine, and on the right side, we have 1 chlorine. So I need to put 4 in front of HCl. Right now, number of chlorine is balanced. Number of silicon is balanced. Then let's balance number of oxygen. Here we have only 1 oxygen, and here we have 4 oxygen. So I need to put number 4 in front of water. So right now silicon, chlorine and oxygen are balanced. But let's double check with hydrogen to make sure everything is balanced. We have 4 times 2, 8 hydrogen here. We have 4 hydrogen here. And we have 4 hydrogen here. So on the both sides, we also have same number of hydrogen. So this equation is balanced right now. Let's work on reaction of tetraphosphorus decaoxide and water. I'm going to start with phosphorus. We have 4 phosphorus on the left side and we have 1 phosphorus on the right side. So I need to put 4 in front of phosphoric acid. So let's start to balancing number of hydrogen. On the right side right now we have 12 hydrogen. And on the left side we have only 2 hydrogen. So I need to put number 6 for water here. Right now phosphorus and hydrogen are balanced. Let's double check with oxygen to make sure everything is balanced in this equation. We have 10 oxygen here and we have 6 oxygen from water. So on the left side we have 16 oxygen. On the right side 4 times 4 we have 16 oxygen too. So everything is balanced right now. And this is our balanced equation. Let's work on reaction of bromine and fluorine that can produce bromine heptafluoride. On the left side here we have 2 bromine atom. On the right side we have 1 bromine atom. Then I need to put number 2 here for bromine heptafluoride. Then we need to balance fluorine. On the right side, we have 2 times 7, 14 fluorine. On the left side, we have only 2 fluorine. So I need to put 7 here. Then this equation is balanced right now. In this example, we have reaction of iron 3 chloride and sulfuric acid. So first, I'm going to balance iron. On the left side, we have 1 iron. On the right side, we have 2 iron. So I need to put number 2 here in front of iron chloride. The next step, I would like to balance chlorine. Right now, on the left side of this equation, we have 6 chlorine, 2 times 3. And on the right side, we have only 1 chlorine. So all I need to do is just put number 6 here. For HCl. So right now iron and chlorine are balanced in this equation. To make it easier, instead of balancing hydrogen and oxygen, I can balance number of SO4 in this equation. We have 3 sulfate here, so we should have 3 sulfuric acid here. Then we can double check with hydrogen too. We have 6 hydrogen on the right side and we have 6 hydrogen on the left side too. So this equation is balanced. Here is the last example for balancing of equations. I'm going to start with iron. We have 2 iron on the left side. And we have only 1 iron on the right side. So I can make iron balance but put number 2 here. Then I can balance number of hydroxide. On the right side for iron hydroxide, we have 6 OH or hydroxide anion. On the left side, we have only 1 OH. So I can put 6 here for balancing of hydroxide anion. After that, I'm able to either balancing number of potassium or number of sulfate for completing this balancing. I'm going to work with potassium. We have 6 potassium here and we have 2 potassium here. Then I need to put 3 here. I could find this number 3 by checking number of sulfate on the left side and on the right side. So either way, we have the same answer. And of course, iron sulfate here should have 1. And this equation is balanced right now. Thank you for watching this video. For watching more video, please subscribe our YouTube channel.